Sí, realmente
What's
sí,
up,
es así.
Insecure King? So guys, today I actually just want to teach you guys a concept. I call it how to use the trend is your friend concept or theory. So I just want to show you how I trade trends. That's all I use. I don't trade like how other people say support and resistance or anything like that. I strictly trade trends. So like the concept of this whole idea, trading trends would obviously be support and resistance, right? So we know basically this would be the concept. If we see price range from point A to point B, basically we can establish that this over here is our resistance zone area, and over here it is our support zone area, right? But this is a concept, right? Price, I trade price action, and the market doesn't move like this. This is how the concept is, but the market does not move like this. So I just want to show you how what I actually mean, right? So people trade this support and resistance type, but let me just give you guys a brief summary of how I actually trade. So we can I trade trends, right? So we can establish it like this is going to be is a bullish trend, right? This is how I trade. So guys, this is not for beginner friendly or anything like that. This is just my concept. I just want people to like maybe capitalize. Maybe this can help you guys. But this is basically how I trade, right? So I trade basically like this. This is a bullish trend, right? So I establish the trend, or yeah, the trend if it's bullish or bearish. At this moment, you can see bullish, right? So every time the market gets over here, I'll take short-term sells, and then long-term buys, right? As you can see in a bullish trend, as you can see this low. Higher lows, right, is being created, and high highs is also being created, right? So yeah, that's basically it. So I basically trade trends, right? I do not, however, trade within like in the middle of trends, right? So we can have this concept: your market could be going here, and then the market can be reversing for some of. As you can see over here, right? For me, when the market reaches here, it's no man's zones. I would never ever trade the market when it's there. You know, I would rather let it slide and wait for the market to either come to my significant zones. But I want to show you guys something. So over here, right, we have established the concept of support and resistance. So for me, this is my resistance zone over here of the trend, and this is my supporting zone over here of the trend, and vice versa for a bearish trend, right? I don't want to like go too in depth or anything. It's all in my mentorship. You know where to find me, Stellenbosch CPT7600. You know where to get me. Anyway. So basically, let me show you on gold, right? Let me show you how I trade gold. I always trade trends, guys, and it's always like trends within trends. Never confuse like if an old trend has like already like been broken. Let me just show you. Let me show you. Then just let go of the trend, right? So let's just say this is how I trade, right? I always trade within the trend, and let's just say it's a bullish trend, correct? And then over here we have something like this. You see the market be ranging, making higher highs, higher low, etc. Right, but when the market breaks this, like the market is creating basically a new trend, right? Let me just show you. So the market broke this over here, guys. Again, this is a theory and a concept, right? We're gonna put it into action like two minutes from now, whatever. But when we see this, right, the market has broken out of this trend, and now over here, right, we can see the market is busy creating a new trend. All right, it's creating a bearish trend. Let me just draw this more accurately so you guys can see. But this is a concept. I want you guys to understand the concept, because once you understand the concept, you can be very profitable within the market. Anyway, and then you can see, okay, cool, yeah, a change of trend. All right, by this moment, I'm erasing the old trend, all right, because it's irrelevant. It's irrelevant. I don't need it anymore. And this will be my new trend that I'll be focusing on, because that was a bullish trend and now it's a bearish trend. And I would be trading within this bearish trend. So I sell at the resistance and buy at the support, right? But to be on the safer side, guys, when it's a bearish trend, I would rather sell more than buy, and vice versa for a bullish trend, you know? So you're on gold on the daily, right? On the daily. Let me show you how I trade trends within trends. It's like very plain and simple. And there's so much opportunity. So let's just see over here. Okay, cool. So we can establish a trend, right? Can establish this beautiful trend, right? You can have even from over there. Doesn't really matter. I just want to show you guys. We can even have something like this. Yeah. something like this, right? Anyway, so we can establish as a police trend, right? Let's just forget over here. I just want to show you on the police trend. Go on the 4 hour. So as you can see, every time the market, let me just throw this more like accurately in a way so you can understand. So as you can see, this was a beautiful, beautiful setup by gold. This was a few weeks back, right? So as you can see, this is a trend, right? We've established this is a bullish trend. And look over here. So here's a touch, right? Every time the market or price comes over here, we are looking for buys. You can even see something like this. That could be also something I'm going to show you how we would be able to trade this. Anywho, and here, right? Every time the market has came to the supporting trend line, I would buy, right? But we need more confirmation. We can't just see this is happening and then we're like, okay, cool, we want to enter. I'm going to show you guys how I enter on these type of setups as well, you know? This is just to get you guys a brief summary or idea of how I actually trade within the Forex market. Because like once upon a time, someone told me Forex is a scam. So I was like, you know, I wasn't even excited or anything like that. I just left him, you know? Because like, there's a real business. Just because it's so quick and easy to access it, doesn't mean this is meant for everyone, you know? But anyway, so as you can see here, when I'm here, supporting trend line, I'm buying. But within this trend, we got some patterns as well, you know? So if you guys, everything online is for free. If you guys don't know about patterns or anything like that, please DM me, hit me up, tell me in the comments what you think, et cetera, et cetera. But the patterns that I use refers to Falcon, right? So we know, we got the concept, right, of how the market would like how it would trade support and resistance, right? So for me, here would be my support and here would be my resistance, right? So let me show you the market, how the market moves, because the market does not move in like a vertical line. The market moves like impulse, correction, impulse, correction, impulse, correction, impulse. I always enter on the correction, you know? So it's an impulse phase. We're waiting for that first correction and we're anticipating a continuation impulse phase as well, you know? So that's how the market moves, right? The market strictly does not move like this, how everyone think if they trade support and resistance. The market does not move like that. Price itself does not even move like that. Price will always, like on a higher time frame, if you see a massive impulse, right? Like let's just say on a 4 hour, we see the market give you this push. On the lower time frames, you would see the market will actually be moving like this, you know? That is giving us opportunities to capitalize, you know? We evolve with the market. We are moving with the market and not against the market. That's why this whole theory is basically the trend is your friend, you know? So you should trade with the trend. Anyway, so here we're looking at the 4 hour and we established this is a bullish trend, right? Using Falcon patterns, like these patterns will like be continuation patterns as the case may be. Anyway, so as you can see something over here, let me just get this concept over. Cool, we can see something like this, right? So we can see the market has been pushing. This could be a correction, impulse, correction again, impulse, correction, impulse, correction, as you can see, right? So that's how we actually capitalize. So let's just go on the 1 hour. So you can show you guys how I would enter. I always enter like on the 1 hour, guys. I wait for a 1 hour candle to close to get extra confirmation. So as you can see, we have established that first impulse, right? Like this a multitude of impulses and correction. We have one here as well, right? This is like so much opportunity for us to like capitalize. And guys, this is gold. Everyone knows gold is very volatile, but look at this beautiful opportunities that gold has actually presented us, right? This is like, you can like on Veracity, guys, you guys can trade 100 Rand accounts, 200 Rand accounts. So guys, there's so much opportunity in the Forex market, you know, if you just understand the concepts, if you just know how to trade the concepts, actually, you know, you can't just come into the market like blindly or anything like that. Anyway, I'm just going to leave this with ease. Could have something like this as well. Okay, fantastic. So let's just go over here, right? So we saw this is a impulse, as you can see. Just get this impulse, correction, impulse. This is another correction here, right? And this correction over here, what is significant about this correction is the fact that it's here about supporting zone, right, of a trend line. So you could have something easily like this, right? Something like that even. Doesn't really matter. Something like that. We could have another pattern within this pattern, as you can see. All right. Fantastic. So you could have easily capitalized. Let me show you my first entry over here. I would have waited for this candle, right? So this candle over here gave us a nice push and 1 hour close like that. And then started moving correctly, right? So I would have taken this trade right here on the breakout. Actually, I think I did take this trade on the breakout. And my stop loss is just below, right? Just below that trend line. And I would have targeted that 90% rule first. You know? That's my first entry, right? But as you can see, there's so many potential within the market to actually capitalize. Let's just go to another one. Like, sometimes it's messy, right? So expanding pattern right over here, falcon flag. We got a one touch, a two touch, basically a third touch over here. We had to do this, like, could have even have it like this. One touch, two touch, three touch, could have capitalized over here or even here, right? As you can see, guys, that's basically it that I have. And I just want to show you something. Now this, we've established as a bullish trend, right? When this bullish trend is broken, as you can see here again. So you can see this bullish trend has been broken, right? Could have easily. Once a bullish trend has been broken, we can establish that a new trend is forming, right? A bearish trend. And as you can see, gold is pretty bearish. Right, and my concept is I like trading out on the breakout, so we have something like this over there, right? On the breakout, 0% drawdown, and you could still capitalize, right? So, guys, if you guys want to just comment, if you guys want to see more videos like this, this is basically my theory of how I trade with the trend and not against the trend, and it's just easy to capitalize. Anyway, it's your boy, Shakur King. Stay safe. Yeah.